Three, two, one. I'm Jay.
And I'm James from the band Tesseract, and welcome to the two-part series on Tesseract Time Signatures.
On the Hack Music Theory Show.
Nailed it!
Changing things up this week for two reasons.
Firstly, our good old chums and prog rock legends, Tesseract, were in Vancouver last night, so we got to hang out and catch up.
And secondly, we reached 80,000 subscribers this week. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts to each and every one of you for joining our Hack Music Theory Revolution.
Yeah, we only started our YouTube channel last year, and this time last year, we had about 80 subscribers.
So to celebrate this milestone and the revolution that we're all creating here together, we're making you a special series on Tesseract time signatures.
Tesseract has a truly refreshing approach to time signatures. So in these videos, you'll learn their hacks to liberate your chord progressions and riffs from 4-4.
And by the way, if you're new to our channel, I'm Kate Harmony, this is Ray Harmony.
And you're watching the Hack Music Theory Show, where you are empowered with notation-free theory for making great music. Alright, let's get cracking. So, we're going to focus on the theory behind their lead single, Luminary, from the new masterpiece of an album, Sonder.
If you haven't heard Luminary yet, do yourself a favor and pause this video right now and go have a listen at tesseractband.co.uk.
And while you're there, check out the cities and dates of their world tour, because you do not want to miss this band live. They're one of the tightest bands we've ever seen.
Right, back to the theory. Tesseract are renowned for perfectly balancing the artistic with the accessible, resulting in incredibly intelligent and creative songs that are also super catchy.
And this is why they appeal to music lovers of all genres.
And why the theory in this series can be used in all genres too.
Right, without further ado, it's time to reveal the theory acts behind Tesseract's wizardry. But first, two.
Hack one. Wrong time, right place.
This hack is what Tesseract geniusly use in their Luminary chorus, which is in the key of D minor, aka D Aeolian. And that is what you're seeing on your screen right now.
So if you want an epic chorus like Luminary, start by writing a chord progression in a minor key.
But here's the problem. There's already a zillion other songs with minor key choruses. So how do you make yours unique?
Easy. You just use this hack.
Before we reveal it though, if you're a beginner or if you just want a little refresher, then please read our free book, 12 Music Theory Hacks to Learn Scales and Chords.
The link is below.
Right, here's how the wrong time, right place hack works.
There's only 7 triads in a minor key, and those are on your screen now. So obviously your chord options are extremely limited.
However, there are literally an infinite amount of harmonic rhythms and time signatures you can use for your chord progression.
So the right place part of this hack is all about choosing the right chords. In other words, any of these 7.
And the wrong time part of this hack is all about playing those chords in an unpredictable harmonic rhythm within an unpredictable time signature. Or two, like in the Luminary chorus. Now, here's how you can use this hack in your own music in 3 simple steps.
Step 1. To get that powerful Luminary feel, set your tempo to 78 BPM, and you're good to 2 bars of 12-8.
Yeah, and 12-8 is in the family of time signatures known as compound time, which divides the music into groups of 3 eighth notes, which is more drawn out so it feels more dramatic than time signatures in the simple time family like 4-4, which uses groups of 2 eighth notes.
Step 2. Decide what chords you want to use from the key of D minor, and draw on each chord's root note on your grid. You can fill in the rest of the notes later.
So, here's the chord progression that we wrote. In our first bar, we chose 4 chords. We started with D minor, then we went up to B flat major, and then down to C major, and then up to A minor. Then we wanted to kick things up in the second bar, so we chose 6 chords. We started with B flat major, then we went up to G minor and up to A minor, and then we went down to C major, and then up to A minor, and finishing with B flat major.
And finally, step 3. Apply the wrong time part of this hack to your chord progression.
Yeah, so this is where Tesseract masterfully twists their 2 bars of 12-8 into 1 bar of 11-8 and 1 bar of 13-8, resulting in 2 odd time signatures replacing 1 even time signature. It doesn't get better than that.
To pull off this magic trick, all you need to do is steal 1 eighth note from bar 2 and donate it to bar 1.
Yeah, and the easiest way to do that is to just choose a chord in bar 1 that you want to shorten and a chord in bar 2 that you want to lengthen. So in bar 1 we decided to shorten the B flat major, and in bar 2 we decided to lengthen the A minor. Now select all the chords in between those two chords you just changed and move all that MIDI an eighth note earlier.
Ta-da! Your chorus just got the Tesseract wrong time, right place makeover.
Yeah, and you'll notice we now have an unpredictable pattern of groups of 3 8th notes and groups of 2 8th notes. And that's exactly what transforms this chord progression from ordinary to extraordinary.
And just a little bonus step for you to make the most of your new and improved harmonic rhythm, be sure to accent the chord changes with your drums.
Yeah, so for example, when you write your drum part for this chord progression, start by putting a kick drum here, a snare drum here, a kick drum here, a snare drum here, and so on. And just before the final playthrough, remember to stay tuned for part 2 of our Tesseract Time Signature series.
And if you like these hacks, then please subscribe and hit the bell to get notifications.
Thanks for joining our Hack Music Theory Revolution.
We'll see you next time.